Forget NRF, Bluetooth, 433 MHz modules, even Wi-Fi. There is a better way to do wireless. I am Nick from educates.tv and today I am showing you ESP-NOW, a game-changing protocol built right into the ESP32 that lets your devices talk instantly, reliably and without the headaches of traditional wireless setups. We will use it to build a wireless weather station, streaming real-time sensor data between ESP32s and displaying it on a big screen. And we will do that in less than 10 minutes. Are you ready to upgrade your wireless game? Let's get started. Did you know that this little ESP32 board already has everything we need to send data wirelessly to another device without the use of Wi-Fi? That's right, without any extra modules, antennas, or anything else. It is all built right in. And that's thanks to something called ESP-NOW. ESP-NOW is a lightweight, connectionless wireless protocol developed by Expressive, the makers of the ESP32. Unlike Wi-Fi or Bluetooth, which require handshaking, authentication, and complex setup processes, ESP-NOW allows devices to communicate instantly and directly with each other. Think of it like a walkie-talkie system for ESP32s. One device sends data, and another receives it without needing an internet connection, a router, or even prior pairing. This makes it fast, efficient, and incredibly easy to use for IoT projects, sensor networks, and real-time data sharing. One of the biggest advantages of ESP-NOW is its low power consumption. Because it doesn't rely on constant network connections or background communication overhead, it's perfect for battery-powered applications, like remote sensors, weather stations, and smart home devices. It also supports one-to-one, one-to-many, and even many-to-many communication, meaning you can set up a network of ESP devices that exchange data easily. And despite its simplicity, ESP-NOW can encrypt data for security, making it a powerful yet lightweight alternative to traditional wireless options. Okay, great, now that you know what ESP-NOW is all about, let's get practical. In this video, we are going to demonstrate the absolute easiest way to get started with ESP-NOW. We are going to set up one ESP32 to send out a message, but not to any specific device. Instead of targeting a specific address, we will use something called broadcasting. This means our sending ESP32 will shout out its message to anyone who is listening on the ESP-NOW channel. And the cool thing is, any ESP32 device nearby can pick up this message. No need to pre-program addresses, no complicated pairing lists. Just send data out into the wireless ether, and any ESP32 that's ready to listen can receive it. This is perfect for simple data broadcasting, like our weather station, where we want to send sensor readings out for any display unit to pick up. Keep in mind that ESP-NOW is actually a very advanced protocol with many features, but today we are just taking our first steps, and I'll be preparing more advanced videos to explore its full potential in the future. But before we jump into the weather station, let's start with something even simpler. We are going to build the absolute minimal ESP-NOW project. In this example, we will have one ESP32 simply sent out. A number, let's say just a counter that increases every second, and a text message, the classic hello world. That's it. No sensors, no displays, just pure basic ESP-NOW communication. This will show you just how easy it is to get two ESP32s talking wirelessly using ESP-NOW. Once we have this basic communication working, then we will move on to building our wireless weather station and see how we can use ESP-NOW to send real sensor data and display it out on our screen. Before we dive into the project, I want to thank today's sponsor, PCBWay. If you are building complex projects on a breadboard, you know that breadboard prototypes can only take you so far. That's where PCBWay comes in. They are a one-stop shop for all your PCB needs, offering high-quality circuit boards starting at just $5 for 10 pieces, with professional-grade manufacturing that ensures your projects work reliably every time. What I especially love about PCBWay is their incredibly fast turnaround. they can manufacture and ship your boards in as little as 24 hours. And it is not just PCBs. They offer full assembly services using advanced automated systems, so they can handle everything from simple boards to complex projects. Their online platform makes it super easy to upload your designs, get instant quotes, and track your order from production to delivery. Get $5 off your first order by using the link in the description below. Now, let's get back to our project. To make ESP-NOW incredibly simple, I have created a special ESP-NOW-Easy class. This class is provided as two simple files, an ESP-NOW-Easy.h file and an ESP-NOW-Easy.cpp file. You just need to include these two files in your Arduino project, and you'll have all the magic of this class at your fingertips. Before we can use this class in our Arduino code, we need to import its header file. Just like any Arduino library, you do this at the very top of your sketch with an include statement. Simply add this line. This makes all the features of the ESP-NOW-Easy class available in your code. Now, before we create our ESP-NOW helper object, we first need to tell the ESP-NOW-Easy class what kind of data it will be sending. Remember we said we would send a number and a message in our basic example. To define this data, we create a custom data structure. Think of it as designing a special box to hold our specific data. It looks like this. Struct, message, curly brackets. Inside this struct, we define the pieces of our data our box will hold. For our example, we want to send an integer, we will call it counter, and a message, a text string, hello world, stored in a character array called text. Once we have defined this message structure, telling ESP-NOW-Easy what kind of data to expect, then we can create our ESP-NOW-Easy object, our ESP-NOW helper. And when we create this object, we need to tell it which message structure to use. We do that with this line of code, ESP-NOW-Easy, brackets, message, ESP-NOW. See, just one line, and we now have our ESP-NOW object specifically designed to handle our message data type, ready to make wireless communication super easy. Now, let's send a message. To begin, we need to initialize the ESP-NOW protocol. With our ESP-NOW-Easy class, this is incredibly simple. We just use this line, ESP-NOW.begin. Next, let's prepare our first data package. We will set our counter to 0 and the text message to hello world. Once our data to send structure is filled with this information, sending it wirelessly is just as easy. ESP-NOW.send parentheses data to send. And that's all there is to it. Believe it or not, with the ESP-NOW-Easy library, sending data is truly this simple, just a few lines of code. To make our example a bit more dynamic, let's move the data sending and counter incrementing into the loop function. This way, we can increase the counter after each message is sent, ensuring we transmit a different value every time. Finally, adding a short delay of 1 second between each send will make it easier to observe the data transmission. We are ready. Let's upload this code to an ESP32 device. Okay, the transmitter is ready. It sends out a new message every second, not to a specific device, but to any device around. Now let's create the receiver sketch. The receiver code is just as simple as the sender. In fact, it shares a lot of similarities. First, just like the sender, the receiver needs to understand the structure of the message it's going to receive. This means we need to define the exact same message struct in our receiver code. Next, just like in the sender, we create our ESP-NOW-Easy object. Now, in the setup function, the first crucial step is to initialize the ESP-NOW protocol itself using ESP-NOW-Begin. Then we configure the receiver to listen for incoming messages by calling the onReceive method and telling it to use the onMessageReceived function as the handler. Think of this function as a dedicated little worker inside your receiver ESP32. Its only job is to wait patiently for ESP-NOW messages to arrive wirelessly. And when a message does come in, this function automatically springs into action. This type of function is often called a callback function. It is not a function that we call directly in our main loop. Instead, we register it with this line of code. After that registration, the ESP-NOW-Easy library takes over and automatically calls the onMessageReceived function for us whenever a new message arrives. Inside the onMessageReceived function, the magic variable is receivedMessage. Notice that receivedMessage is a type message ampersand. This means it is a reference to a message structure. When ESP-NOW-Easy calls onMessageReceived, it automatically fills this receivedMessage structure with the data from the wirelessly received message. So inside this function, we can directly access the data from the incoming message using receivedMessage.counter and receivedMessage.text. We can then do whatever we want with this received data. In our example, we simply print it to the serial monitor. But in a real project, you might use this data to update a display, control motors, trigger actions, or anything else you can imagine. We are all set. Let's upload this receiver code to a second ESP32 board. To really show you how versatile ESP-NOW is, I'm even going to use a different ESP32 model for the receiver. This time, an ESP32-S3 board. And look at this, it works perfectly. Over on the serial monitor, we can see the messages arriving wirelessly. So there you have it, in just a few minutes and with minimal code, we have successfully established wireless communication between two ESP32 boards using ESP-NOW and our ESP-NOW-Easy class. If you found this introduction to ESP-NOW and the ESP-NOW-Easy class helpful and easy to follow, please give this video a like. It really helps more people discover this simple and powerful wireless technique for their ESP32 projects. Using the exact same ESP-NOW foundation we just built, I have connected a BME280 sensor to our center ESP32. And now, instead of sending a simple counter and a hello world message, we are transmitting real-world environmental data, temperature, humidity, and barometric pressure directly from the sensor. That data is then captured by another ESP32 board and displayed on a big 2.8-inch screen. Let's quickly look at the code changes, starting with the transmitter. The main adjustment, as you might expect, is modifying our data structure to match the sensor readings. Let's take a look at the weather data structure for our weather station. You'll see we have essentially redesigned our data books to specifically hold temperature, humidity, and pressure values. And the great thing is, because we are using the ESP-NOW-Easy class, the fundamental ESP-NOW sending process remains unchanged. We still use the ESP-NOW begin in setup and ESP-NOW send data to send in the loop. The ESP-NOW Easy library handles this new weather data structure without any other change in the code. The only real change is that now the data is generated from the sensor. Now, turning to the ESP32 receiver, I have connected an ILI9341 display. This allows our receiver to function as a dedicated weather display unit. The key to managing this incoming data is our onWeatherDataReceived function, our special callback, acting as the receiver's data processor. Every time the ESP32 receives a weather update, this function springs to life. Inside, we first send the data to the serial monitor for easy verification. Then we just call the update method of the display class to display the new readings from the sensor on the screen. Now let's talk about the range and reliability for a moment. In my testing, ESP-NOW has been surprisingly robust. I have been able to walk around my house with these ESP32s and the weather data keeps streaming perfectly without losing a single data packet. Honestly, for this kind of local in-home wireless communication, I have found ESP-NOW to be far more reliable than any Bluetooth 433 MHz or NRF module setup I have ever used. It just works, and works consistently. And what's even more exciting is that ESP-NOW is capable of even greater range, up to 400 meters. And that's something I'll be exploring in detail in another video soon, so stay tuned. You can find the code for this project and the wiring schematics at the link in the video description below. And if you are interested in building a more advanced wireless weather station with even more features, stay tuned. I'll be creating a separate video soon with detailed step-by-step instruction. Until then, watch this ESP32 project. I think you are going to like it.